Muy buenos días a todos y a todas. Bienvenidos a la segunda versión de 8.8 Lovelace. Como algunos saben, el año pasado fue la primera versión de 8.8 Lovelace y el objetivo es crear una instancia para las mujeres expositoras para darles más ánimo a meterse a la ciberseguridad y a enviar sus investigaciones a nuestro call for paper. Igual que la 8.8 general, tenemos un call for paper donde recibimos los papers de investigadores y hackers y para que puedan participar en nuestro evento. Lovelace toma su nombre en homenaje a Augusta Ada King, que es considerada la primera programadora de ordenadores. Ahora paso la palabra a mi co-coordinadora Natalia Palacios de Duoc.
Hola. Muy buenos días, les damos la más cordial bienvenida a esta nueva versión de la 8.8 Lovelace, en la cual buscamos generar un espacio para incentivar la participación de más mujeres en ciberseguridad. Hoy la ciberseguridad se ha convertido en uno de los campos de tecnología de mayor crecimiento en todo el mundo. A pesar de este crecimiento continuo y de las nuevas oportunidades en esta área, la representación de las mujeres en la fuerza laboral y ciberseguridad sigue siendo muy baja, incluso más que en las tecnologías de información. Necesitamos más mujeres en TI y en ciberseguridad porque el desarrollo social y económico de nuestros países alcanzará su máximo potencial cuando exista diversidad de talentos, de visiones, de edades y logremos equidad de género. Espero que el programa que hemos desarrollado para ustedes sea de interés y aporte a la discusión sobre los nuevos desafíos que nos presenta la ciberseguridad. Bienvenidos y bienvenidas, que tengan una excelente jornada.
Queremos aprovechar también para agradecer profundamente a las charlistas, panelistas y participantes que tenemos hoy y además a los patrocinadores que hacen posible hacer este evento: Nasdaq, Tecnoban, 0x World y My Public Inbox. Además a las comunidades que nos han apoyado con difusión del evento, que es Hackadar, Hackgirls y Desafío Latam. Ahora paso la palabra a mi otra co-coordinadora, que es Lisbeth Plata, vicepresidenta de WOMSI.
Hola Lice, Natalia, muchísimas gracias. Estoy súper, súper emocionada de participar por segundo año consecutivo en el comité organizador de este gran evento 8.8 Lovelace. Todos sabemos que estos años de pandemia han sido pues muy distintos a lo que estábamos acostumbrados, tanto en la casa, en el trabajo, en el colegio, inclusive en la forma en cómo organizamos los eventos. Puedo decir que la organización de este evento ha sido un gran desafío y hemos aprendido a hacer cosas distintas de una manera distinta. Y lo que sí hemos identificado es la importancia de la tecnología en estos momentos. Aquí les quiero comentar algo sumamente importante, y es que en estos últimos años, meses, la ciberseguridad y por supuesto la protección de datos ha tomado una gran relevancia. Y en este momento quiero, por supuesto, que quieran disfrutar y compartirles algunas recomendaciones para durante el evento. La primera de ellas es que sabemos que la tecnología en cualquier momento puede fallar, nos pueden llamar en cualquier momento, así que si se cae, no se preocupe, manténganse en línea, que nuestro equipo técnico va a estar haciendo todo lo posible para que ustedes puedan volver a la conexión. Así que muchas gracias por la comprensión y por la paciencia. Este evento ha sido organizado para ustedes, así que si tienen alguna pregunta, felicitaciones, opinión, no duden en hacerla directamente en el chat y se las vamos a compartir a nuestros speakers y expositores. Así que recordemos que esta es una instancia de aprendizaje. El día de hoy es un día maravilloso. Les compartimos, les comentamos que vamos a contar con 6 charlas y un panel y vamos a contar con traducción simultánea. Así que en el correo que recibieron de Pathline encontrarán 2 links. Uno en el idioma original del speaker, bien sea en español o bien sea en inglés, y el otro con la traducción. Así que sientan la libertad de intercambiarse entre los diferentes speakers, ¿ok? En este momento, quiero presentar a nuestra primera expositora o speaker del día. Quiero iniciar por presentar a Selene Yuponi. Selene Yuponi nos acompaña el día de hoy. Selene es ingeniera de TI especializada en forense digital e investigaciones cibernéticas y trabaja junto con Lea. fiscales y organismos gubernamentales nacionales e internacionales desde el año 2008. Es directora general del REA Security Inc. para Europa y está totalmente centrado en todo lo que es Cyber Threat Intelligence y operaciones especiales. Adicionalmente, es miembro activo del Consejo Europeo de Women for Cyber. Es una organización europea de ciberseguridad. Esta fue una iniciativa lanzada en enero del 2019 con el apoyo de la Comisión Europea y luego se convirtió en una fundación alrededor de septiembre del 2019. Y también es fundadora del capítulo Italia. Así que, Selene, welcome to 8.8 Lovelace. It's a pleasure to have you here in our opening keynote. How are you?
Hello, thank you. Thank you for the invitation. Thank you all the ladies, but also to the gentlemen that is follow us. And thank you for again. So in my keynote, I would like to speak about IXO and also about Women for Cyber project. So why women are important in the cybersecurity life cycle? So it was a long time ago, I starting with my career into the IT field, not a computer as a computer engineering, as Elizabeth presented me. And I starting when I was very young into my career. Into this last year, I saw a lot of gender gap, unfortunately, not only for knowledge, but also for the problem about budget, money, and so on. I'm founder of the European Cybersecurity Organization. I'm a founder member, and the EXO was born in July 2016. And from last December, in December 2020, I became council member of Women for Cyber Europe. In these days, we are launching Women for Cyber Italy chapter. So we're starting with the conference next week on 15th of July. So, what is EXO? EXO is a European cybersecurity organization, not profit organization. It's a it's a cooperation between public and private partnership. We sign this agreement directly with the European Commission. And we have internally into EXO some initiatives. The first one and the most important one at the moment, and we're pushing a lot, it is Women for Cyber. And then we have also other also initiative. But for example, a lot of information, but also a survey and analysis about the CISO, the challenge. We did a lot of job and we identify also into IXO different sector between energy, finance, food, health, a lot of industries, but with the common part of cybersecurity to be more secure, to have an Europe also more secure. But speaking about our goal and our main topic, it was Women for Cyber, and I'm very proud to be into this kind of initiative. This initiative was launched by the European Cybersecurity Organization on 2 years ago, on 22 January in 2019, under the patronage and in presence of Maria Gabriel, that's the European Commissioner for the Digital Economy and Society. IXO has a lot of founding members, but also European female leaders and ambassador of Women for Cyber, in particular also to take part at the European Commission. They kick off the first meeting was on 22 January 2019. And we identify the Women for Cyber objective and also the roadmap of action. And also into working progress, we had also a lot of other action to be added into this kind of initiative. And what are the key messages of the Women for Cyber? Who are we? And we can export also Women for Cyber abroad. And then I'll show you also each kind of chapter that was built up. Who are we? We are, of course, a non-profit private foundation that we promote, encourage, but also we support all the women, not only the professional women, but also from students. We starting this kind of job, women into cybersecurity. It's a multi-level initiative, and we have also some partnership with other organizations locally or globally from directly from the ICSO. So it's not only, of course, women, but we have also men into our national chapter, because we promote knowledge, we promote training, awareness, we promote also some other kind of initiative, gender gap or scientific committee, but also we work together with men and women, so to not have a specific gender gap into cybersecurity domain. I remember when I started at the university, computer engineer, we were just three ladies and the rest, of course, men. But when I started also my master class with the law enforcement, with the Italian Postal Police, I was the only woman, but also other master that I attended in the past, I was the only woman. So this is why I'm starting, and I'm also very active in this initiative, because I would like to promote this kind of gender gap, of course, and I would like also that the next generation will be not, okay, cybersecurity is not just for men, cybersecurity is also for ladies. And in fact, we are seeing during also my career, a lot of women that programmers, also in hacking conference. I was the speaker in Chile at A.8, but also in other security conference all around Europe and all around the world. And finally, I'm starting to see that there are also women that participate not only as participants, but also as a speaker. So what do we stand for? So we know that cybersecurity is not only the technical part, but we promote also the other kind of skill, also the soft skill. For example, I'm starting with the digital forensics field, and now I'm in the cyber threat intelligence field. So to identify and to have some cyber investigation. And what I discovered, that we have to approach with the, also to solve some problem with holistic approach. There is not just a technical approach, but also other kind, the psychological, the geopolitical, the legal, the part of public correlation. And a lot of time when I have this kind of hybrid team, we have also more power to solve this kind of cyber investigation, and also with the women inside our team. So what we have at this stage, we have that at this stage, all around the world, this kind of field of cybersecurity field with a lot of specialization, digital forensics, CISO, data protection officer, and other kind of expertise, we have to grow up. And because the cyber criminal, also to contrast cyber criminal, we have to have a big group to solve this kind of problem. And also, I think that the gap and also the key message of Women for Cyber, that the gender inclusion is crucial to in addressing this gap. We already know that all around the world, everyone is going to search cybersecurity specialists, CTI analysts, digital forensics analysts. And we need to attract. So this is why we're starting also with our first meeting that we had, and also public presentation that we had in Italy with Women for Cyber, we push to have a lot of students, not only male but also female. So we need to attract women into the cybersecurity career. So, because we know that women, see, so it's just to fix this gender gap, that is not only a work, a job for men. What we do from the council member, so the main from Women for Cyber in Brussels, we can have four objectives. So identify and link a strong community of women in cybersecurity. Also, because we think that together we have more power. Then, as I told you before, support the awareness, the education, training, and also the employment. So, new way also to employ women into the cybersecurity life cycle in general. The other part, the third part, is support and shape policy at EU, also at the national level with the Women for Cyber message, but also create the national chapter. So we are not just working with the European Cybersecurity Organization and Women for Cyber is just for Europe. So we are growing up, and also in Latin America, just asking a lot of time, okay, we would like to set up Women for Cyber Latin America. Okay, we are ready also to support Women for Cyber in Latin America, but also we are ready to support Women for Cyber in Asia. For example, our president, she's doing also this job. What kind of job also we did? We starting and we decided to launch our registry of experts. So in collaboration with the European Commission, and it's public, you can also join this kind of registry, and it's public to all the ladies. So we can, you can register, and you can add your curriculum, you can add your reference point, and you can add also some expert group. For example, if you prefer the policy one, or the part related to the laws, or related to the technical, of course, part. Because we already know that all around the world, not only Europe, of course, we have a lot of women that are into the main position of also computer companies or IT companies or cybersecurity companies. So, what is the aim of this kind of registry? The registry, it was made to encourage women to come forward, to become, to have also more visibility and into this kind of cybersecurity field, but also to be more active. And the registry, as I told you before, was endorsed and made by the European Commission. And I was very proud to be in this kind of registry because I know into my last 3 years, but also in the into the last, when I was starting as a founder of ICSO, European Cybersecurity Organization, I met a lot of women that they have, that they are at the apical point, not only, as I told you before, cybersecurity company or IT company, but also from a political company, especially into the European Commission. Our role model campaign. So what we have, of course, we have some campaign into our social network, into all the social networks. So you can also follow us on LinkedIn and so on. But when you have the Spotlight Women for Cyber campaign, our role model, okay, we have three different kind of questions. First of all, what is your current position and how it is related this position to a cybersecurity field? What is your original career and why you, at the end, you are into cybersecurity field? But also that it's our main goal at this stage to support the next generation, the our advice, the women advice to the other women or girl that they want to work into cyber. We know that is not so easily, and we know that because it's not easily, also a lot of time we have to, unfortunately, come back, and we are in contrast with a lot of men. But we don't want to lose on to take the same job of the men, but we need at this stage to be paired at the men. Then we realize also as a Women for Cyber Initiative, we realize our book with 100 and more women in cybersecurity in Europe. And this procedure was made through application and nomination through the Women for Cyber website. And we are just a few at this stage, just 120 women decide and choose this kind of to participate into a book. So we are at this stage, we are still finalized the book, but we have to publish this summer. We promote what we are doing, and when we starting, and all with all our activities, we promote action, of course, with masterclass. We promote, and it's public and it's totally free. You can also participate. There is also some masterclass in Spanish because we have Women for Cyber, the chapter, the Spain chapter. So we have one free online masterclass per month, free to everyone. Short presentation also with question and answer, and also the roles models that we chose in agreement with the Secretariat, with Mr. also Luigi Rebuffi, that he is actually the Secretary of Women for Cyber. So not just lady, but also men, as I told you before. And the audience, of course, junior cybersecurity professional, but also other kind of professional and students interested in this kind of field. As I told you before, you can find our masterclass online. You can find the next one on LinkedIn. You can follow us on Instagram or in our Women for Cyber website. The first masterclass was made with the Christine Scropia. And the second one, it was made with Annette Madinator, that she's our president at the Women for Cyber in Brussels. And other kind of masterclass with Elena Santiago Zee and also Rania Stamboliska. So we have a lot. So each month we promote this kind, and as you can see, the topics we're gonna be changing, because we not provide only cybersecurity. No, we provide also non-technical speech, with also building career in cybersecurity or other kind of topics. So we are open to all the topics. And also, I was very proud to know personally Lorena Boalonso, and she did a masterclass, How to Succeed in Cybersecurity, tour with also DigiConnect. And you can find all this kind of masterclass and the recording into our official Women for Cyber website. The sixth masterclass was made with Domitila Benigni. And as I told you before, I'm one of the founder of Women for Cyber Italy chapter. And we are starting, we grew up, and we are accelerate also to promote and to found this kind of chapter. And Domitila, she will be our president. So I'm very proud to work with her daily by daily. And into her masterclass, she promotes from strategic autonomy to technological sovereignty. In the case of cybersecurity and why the women are important, I recommend to follow and to see the registration of this kind of masterclass, because also Domitila, she's starting as electronic engineer with all men. And then she grew up also internally. So it was a lot of stories about women related to this kind of field, but also the problem that we had into this kind of field. We are building, of course, the Women for Cyber national and local chapter. We are doing the country, or the creation for country, for local territory, and also the pan, the regional one. So also with interregional cooperation. As I told you, it was not only for Europe, but we are starting to promote still in Asia, and now we are promoting in Latin America. So the operational committee, and I'm one of the council member of Women for Cyber in Brussels, but we are, and we saw to grow up very quickly all of this kind of chapter from the North Macedonia, Albania, Spain, Lithuania, Luxembourg, Serbia, and now at the last one, the Italy. So on our also LinkedIn page and also on my private page, I'm going to publish all these updates about Women for Cyber Italy chapter. So I would like to leave you with one question. Why we don't have to work into cybersecurity field? I know also in my career that I grew up with the cybersecurity, and we would like that other women and girls come to help us also to fight cybercrime. Thank you again. Hi, Lisa.
It, Estamos al aire.
I leave here my also the Women for Cyber chapter, the secretary, because
Hello. I... ¿Me escuchan?
Can you hear me?
Yes, sorry, I had muted my computer. Hello, Celine, so nice to see you again.
No.
How are you?
Santiago.
Yes, it's, we have a sunny day today, but it's winter and very cold.
Oh.
Thank you so much for being our opening keynote today.
Thank you.
So interesting.
I'm very happy when you called me because we are doing this kind of initiative and promotion about Women for Cyber, and I'm very proud to share with you our experience at the European perspective. Thank you.
Well, thank you. I think it's very important because to grow as a community and to grow as women, it's very important that we connect with each other and that we know the other communities and the other initiatives in the world, and we can, you know, get experience from each other and advice on how to, you know, improve things, how to get more active in cybersecurity, advice as to how to, you know, be in
yeah,
this.
To share also our personal experience. So this is why I propose the audience also to see the registration of the master class. That is free, open to everyone, because each kind of women, and not just the technical women, promote and support, and also they share their experience, their own experience. And I think it's so important also for the next generation.
I think so too. And we actually, I have one question here.
Yes.
I have Leticia, she's asking, how can I, ¿cómo puedo decir? Ah, no, she's asking about WOMSI. WOMSI is a different organization. But maybe it's, can you be a member of the Cyber for Women, or do you have to open a chapter in your own country?
Okay. Yeah. You can follow, of course, the registry, the Women for Cyber registry at the European Commission. So also if you are in Latin America, you can join. But we are open as Women for Cyber in Brussels. As I told you, for Asia, we would like also to support you if you would like to open national chapter in Latin America.
Okay. So if we have a group of women here who are interested, they can open a chapter and talk directly to you about how to,
of course,
to do that,
of
to
course,
become part of the organization.
Why not? We are joyful, okay. We are happy.
Okay, I'm just seeing here if there are any more questions in the other groups. No, I don't see any questions.
Yo hablo un poquito de español.
Ah, muy bien. Se parece al italiano.
Sí. Sí, sí. Pero no es muy bueno.
No, it's fine. It's fine.
Okay.
Annie is asking for which is the contact you showed on the screen.
Okay, secretary. The secretaria. It's our secretaria. Just a moment. I'm sharing you again. It's just the secretaria. It's our Italian secretary mail. It's womenforcyber.it, but you can find also secretary or hello or info. But Lise, if also the audience want, I can share with you my slides so you can find all the contacts.
Okay, that would be great.
Yeah.
That would be great if you can share it so people have the information if they want to contact you or somehow find out more information. Maybe people need a little time to digest all the new information and see if they're interested in participating or maybe opening a chapter here. We have many very active communities, women cyber communities here now. So it's very possible.
I saw from the logo.
Yes. We have different communities. So that's very good. I think that. And we have many new events also, women coming together doing events like this 8-8 Lovelies, but other events, other organizations. So I think that is very positive that we connect as women and together we're stronger. Not that exactly. We have to fight the men, we don't hate men. but I think it's important because people sometimes need, you know, they feel maybe a little more comfortable being in a women's community, asking questions to other women.
Yeah.
That's actually one of the points with 8.8, that this was supposed to be obviously a physical event where we would all be together. And exactly. The idea with 8.8 was to give women the space to just be women on the scenario. Maybe feel more confident about it.
Yeah, so this is why we also promote into the school Women for Cyber, because we would like that the next generation, the girls, cybersecurity is not only for men, you can do, and is also for women.
Yes, I think it's very important, and I think that happily there are a lot of different organizations working for more women in technology in general,
We
need much more people working in this because,
of course,
it's been like in any other branch where women have, you know, started being, it had to like open their way until it becomes like normal. Now we're just as many men as women, but it's sort of a fight. I don't think the men want to exclude women. I don't think
men
at all.
It depends.
Very male-dominated areas, and the women have to sort of open their way and find their space and their way of being there, and you know, all the jokes and so on, and and just that we don't think the same way sometimes. I think we all see that at home. Sometimes we think something is very logical and our husbands never thought the same.
No, but so, I think it's better also, and I saw this into my cyber investigation team, that women, a lot of time, we are multitasking and working in a different kind of stuff and thinking also in different way. So it's a good way for problem solving, especially into cybersecurity investigation. Cyber investigation in general. Yeah.
Get a different angle. A woman another idea occurs to a woman that would occur to a man. That's why it's important to have mixed teams, obviously. Every time you're doing something, you need the opinion of sort of both sides. I think that's very important. Yeah. I mean, I guess that's
game.
Yeah, I'm just going to check if anybody else came in with the questions. So we have Leticia asking if there is a Latin American chapter. There's not yet a Latin American
chapter. Not yet. We create it, of course. And we support as IXO and the Women for Cyber from Brussels, we can help to create it, of course.
Okay, so anybody here present today are most welcome to start thinking about opening a chapter, finding a group of people who are interested. Are men allowed? Is that only women? If you want to create a chapter, is it only women?
No, because we have to think that our secretary, as I mentioned during my speech, he's a man. So the managing part of Women for Cyber in Brussels is Mr. Luigi Rebuffi, and he's a man. And also in Italy, we are including also in our scientific committee or some member, associate member, some men. Of course, we are open to all one because we have to promote training to advisor into school. So it's not just for women, remember.
That's good. Yeah, but it's important to sometimes say it more than once because when you listen, you don't, not everything stays. So it's good to just maybe repeat that. Yes, I think that, is there any other sort of anecdote you can share with us in the work you're doing with Women for Cyber? Do you have any projects that you haven't mentioned coming up or anything else you can share with us?
No, I think this kind of community also, because okay, it's an association with just the founding and also the companies, the not just the cybersecurity company, but also other kind of company, for example, critical infrastructure or industrial automation, can participate into the Women for Cyber initiative. So we are open to everything and to everyone. So we are not just closed as a lot of time, or we are not touching, for example, just some topics. There are some technical associations that they are into cyberbullying, against cyberbullying or revenge porn. No, we are open to all, not just to promote, but also to support. And we can share different kinds of cybersecurity field in general. So we are not focused into one topic. We are open to all. So you are welcome.
Well, it sounds very interesting and very necessary. So
okay. Thank you so much for the invitation.
No, thank you so much for being with us. And we hope to see you in another.
Okay, I hope to see you face to face. Okay, thank you. Yes. Thank you.
Have a great day.
Bye. Bye.
Ah, okay. Bueno, esto fue nuestra primera keynote del día de hoy. Espero que haya sido interesante para todos. Les quiero hacer recuerdo de que vamos a hacer algunos sorteos durante el día. Tenemos algunos libros de 0x Word, que si no lo conocen, es una editorial que publica libros sobre ciberseguridad. Pueden conocer los títulos que tenemos en la tienda de 8.8. El link a la tienda está en la página web. Y vamos a sortear algunos libros de ahí. También vamos a tener algunos sorteos de poleras del año pasado. Que tengo una acá para que, si no la conocen, fue la polera de 8.8 del año pasado. Y además estamos sorteando Tempos. Tempos es como una moneda para usar en MyPublic Inbox. Y MyPublic Inbox es un medio para comunicarse con perfiles públicos. Que de repente uno no puede contactarlos, pero a través de este sistema uno lo puede contactar. Así que vamos a estar también sorteando. De hecho, ya tenemos la ganadora. Voy a revisar ahora el chat para ver quién hizo la primera pregunta. Así que si hay algunas consultas acerca de MyPublic Inbox, igual la pueden hacer acá en el chat para que podamos explicar bien lo que es. Y yo creo que ahora vamos a Sander, ¿cierto? Para luego ir con nuestra próxima expositora.